أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
بسم الله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء اتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن أصدق حديث كتاب الله تعالى وأحسن حديث حديث محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والشر أمور محدثاتها وكل محدثات بدعة كل بدعة ضلالة كل ضلالة في النار أما بعد Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. All praise is due to Allah Azza wa Jal. We praise Him and we extol Him. And we seek refuge in Allah Azza wa Jal from the evil within ourselves and the evil results of our wrong actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can be led astray. And whomsoever Allah Azza wa Jal allows to be left in misguidance, there will be no guide for that person. Really, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the most evil of all affairs are the newly invented ones. And every newly invented matter is a bid'ah, a going astray. And every going astray leads to the hellfire, wa ya'adhu billah. As to what follows, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. I think I speak for all of us here that we all woke up in a sense of peace and security. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. May Allah keep us all in a sense and in that state of peace and security. Ameen. I think I can speak for all of us here that we all woke up without any worries. We can go and look for food and choose what we want. Or what we like to eat, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. But my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this great blessing of Aman, yani being in a state of security, is something that not the whole world can appreciate. When you look at your kids, say Alhamdulillah, that Allah keep you all safe. May Allah keep us all safe. Ameen. But there's a lot of people right now in the world who are very sad. The whole world is saddened. Is in a state of shock and deep, deep regret and sadness at what happened recently in Pakistan with those recent attacks, the blatant attacks on the innocent children, the most innocent of creation is the women and the children. And when you look at your kids, remember that alhamdulillah, Allah are keeping them safe. And may Allah keep us safe. Ameen. But this incident that took place in Pakistan is not the first time. It's been taking place and it's going to continue to take place until we, as the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wake up. Because now everybody is trying to point the blame at who caused this mess. Who did it? Why did this happen? Who's the one to blame? Everybody wants to blame these people. They want to blame those people. They want to blame all kind of agencies and organizations. But we fail to blame ourselves. We're not looking at ourselves. I've mentioned before many occasions that we as Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are not taking the place where we're supposed to be. Allah Azza wa Jal, He did not intend for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be a complacent nation. Allah Azza wa Jal said very explicitly in the Quran, كنت خير أمة أخرج للناس تعملون بالمعروف وتنحون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. Allah Azza wa Jal says explicitly, referring to the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we were intended to be the best nation that has been taken out, that has been taken out of all of the other nations of mankind. And this, Allah Azza wa Jal, He used this word very, very eloquently, أخرج للناس, that Allah Azza wa Jal, He has taken us out. Allah has chosen us, as Allah astafa من الناس. Allah chooses who He wants to be a Rasul, to be a messenger, to be a prophet, to be a righteous person. As I mentioned before, and I will continue to mention that, where we are, where we start off, it does not necessitate where we're going to end up. Some of us can start off in our life as a non-Muslim and end off in the later stages of their life as somebody who was very righteous and pious. Allah Azza wa Jal, in His infinite mercy and blessing upon us, He akhrajna. Of all the people in mankind, Allah, He chose us to be His representatives. Why? He says, because we are supposed to تعمرون بالمعروف, enjoying all that is good. معروف means all that is good, wholesome, and sanctified, holy, pious, everything that is good. وتنحون على المنكر, and we forbid, we stop people from المنكر. So how did this thing happen in Pakistan? How come this thing keeps on happening in Pakistan? Why is there retaliation going on? For what reason? People say it's politics. This is dirty politics. We have no other reason other than to say that this is politics. If we were doing the job that we were intended to do, then these things would have never have taken place. Who are we blaming? We're overlooking ourselves. We're pointing, we're blaming everybody, but we're not looking at ourselves. We wake up in a state of amen, safety and security and peace. We have so many choices to look at in our fridge to eat, in our cupboards. We have so many things that we can eat and we can drink. But what about those people who are crying? If you look, you see the people crying at the loss of their children. They went to school. Now the people are afraid to go to school. Who are we to blame? It is us. The eyewitness report said that the person who perpetrated this crime were people who wore our clothes, they said. They were people who wore our clothes and they spoke our language. They were not foreign people. They were not foreigners. You cannot say that they were African. You cannot say that they were Arab. You cannot say they're anything other than their own people. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said about the Khawarij. When he came to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, Ya Muhammad, kun adl, be just. The Prophet ﷺ said that if I am not just and the wahi comes down to me morning and evening, then who's going to be just? Then he walked away. The Sahaba, they asked, I think it was Khalid ibn Mu'allid, Umar al-Khattab, said, let me chop off his head, Ya Rasulullah. The Prophet ﷺ said, no, leave him. Leave him. You want people going to say that Muhammad kills his companions? The Prophet ﷺ said, from his loins are going to come the Khawarij. And if I were alive at his time, at that time, I would slaughter them like the slaughtering of Ad and Thamud. He said, leave them. This is what the Prophet ﷺ prophesied, that this is going to come about. And right now we're living and we see this reality, that these Khawarij are alive and they're perpetrating their atrocities all over the world. But the problem is on us, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, because we are failing our responsibility. We're passing the buck, as they say. We're blaming everybody else, but we're not blaming ourselves. Why are they targeting little children in Nigeria, these Boko Haram? Why do they want to kidnap the little girls? People say this is politics. Why are they targeting the schoolhouse in Pakistan? Why are they targeting these poor and innocent people, the children? For what reason? People, they say this is politics. There's a hadith, an authentic hadith, what can be Akhraj Imam al-Bukhari, an authority of Nu'man ibn Bashir, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, listen very closely, how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave an example. The example of the person abiding by Allah's orders and limits, or the ones who abides by the limits and regulations set by Allah, in comparison to the one who does wrong, who does not abide by the limits and the orders of Allah, is like the example of people drawing lots to go on a ship. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, the example of these two people, the people who are trying to live and go according to Allah's rules and regulations, and the example of those who try to not live by Allah's rules and regulations, is the example of those people who draw lots to board a ship. Some want to be on the upper part, upper deck of the ship, and some want to be on the lower deck of the ship. Look how the Prophet ﷺ, he gave the example, his teaching example. So those people, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on the lower deck of the ship, they would always have to go to the upper deck of the ship and get water and request for water. And they, at the lower deck of the ship, knew that it was annoying those on the upper deck of the ship from time to time. So one of those in the lower deck of the ship decided to get an axe and make a hole so the water would just spurt up. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said that when one of them on the upper deck of the ship, everybody in the lower deck, they didn't stop him, but one on the upper deck came down and asked him, what are you trying to do? He said, we are tired of annoying you by coming up and going down from getting the water. So I want to just make a hole here and get the water myself. The Prophet ﷺ said that that one from the upper deck said to that person on the lower deck, if you do that, then we will all drown. Then we will all drown. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said that if they were to allow that person, that one person, to make a hole in the bottom of the boat, then everybody on the boat would have drowned. Another example I would like to give. Yani, we're talking about social reform here, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. We, as Allah Azza wa Jalla intended us to be, is the best nation. Why? Because we enjoin what is right and we forbid what is wrong. And we believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla. This ayah that Allah Azza wa Jalla said is not like wal asr. Inna al-insan lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa amila salihat wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr. This ayah is a general ayah that all of mankind, by the time all of mankind will be destroyed, are destroyed, they're in a state of loss and disarray, an illusion, except for those who believe and do righteous good deeds. Illa al-akhir ayah. That ayat is a general ayat, but Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying specifically in this ayat, "Kuntum khair ummatin ukhrijat lin-nas," that we were intended to be the best nation out of all the other people of mankind. Allah chose us out of all mankind, but we don't appreciate that blessing. When are we going to show appreciation for that? Allah Azza wa Jalla has said that we were intended to be the best. Why? Because we enjoy what is good and we forbid what is wrong. We don't just sit back and look at these things and say, oh, astaghfirullah, this is not good, subhanallah. We do something about it. We cannot sit back and watch these atrocities taking place. We have to find ways to do something to help the people. Like our brothers and sisters in Hashem, they're suffering. We have to find ways to try and help those people who are suffering the most when these things take place. When these Khawarij, these people, who the Prophet ﷺ called the dogs of the hellfire, when they do what they do, who suffers the most? The women and the children. So we, as the Ummah of Muhammad ﷺ, we should not sit back complacently and not speak up. There's another excellent example. And we're talking about social reform. It's on the authority of Abu Ya'la. Yani Al-Hafiz Abu Ya'la, he said that one day Umar ibn Khattab, he stood on the member of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was delivering a khutbah on the minbar of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, O people, why do you exaggerate concerning the mahr? Why do you exaggerate concerning the money that you give to your wives as a wedding gift, the mahr? And the Prophet ﷺ and his companions, they did not exaggerate concerning this affair. And they used to not give more than 40 kirtan, yani amount, a weight of gold. They used to not exaggerate and give anything more than that. When Umar ibn Khattab was on the minbar of the Rasul ﷺ telling the people this, a woman stood up. He said, Aqtat ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. He said, you made a mistake, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. Did you not read the Quran? Umar ibn Khattab, he said, what is the ayat? He said, Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, in atat ihdahunna, if you were to give any one of them a mountain size of gold, then don't take it back from them. Umar ibn Khattab, he went back up on the minbar of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, I had just previously told you to not give, not to exaggerate in giving of the dowry. But I take back what I just said previously. And the woman had spoken the truth, and the man, Umar ibn Khattab, had made a mistake. We're talking, my dear brothers and sisters, about social reform. If we are afraid to speak the truth, Umar ibn Khattab was well known amongst his Sahaba about how ferocious he was, how strong he was. He could have punished that lady, but the lady was not afraid to speak the truth. Nowadays, the men are acting even less than women. وَيَعَذِ بِاللَّهِ نَسْلَ الْعَافِيَةِ We're afraid to speak the truth. Simple truth we're afraid to speak. Umar ibn Khattab, the Amir al-Mu'mineen, stood on the minbar and he gave an address, but the lady was not afraid to tell him that what you said is incorrect, according to the Quran and the Sunnah. And him, Umar ibn Khattab, he was not afraid to accept the nasiha. But nowadays we're afraid because the people, they have guns, and we're afraid to tell them the truth. We're afraid that they're going to kill us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's an authentic hadith in the story of Aisha radha anha, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he would wake up at night, he would make this dua. He would say, Allahumma Rabbi Jibra'il wa Mika'il wa Israfil, Fatir al-Samawati wal-Arda, أنت عالم الغيب والشهادة أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كان فيه يختلفون أحديني لما اختلفت فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تحتي من تشاء وإلى صراط مستقيم. Whenever the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would wake up at night, and why else would we wake up at night except we have issues in our life? We have problems we want to solve. We have things we need to ask Allah's guidance for. Whenever the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would wake up at night, he would say, Oh my Lord, the Lord of Jibra'il, the Lord of Mika'il, the Lord of Israfil, creator of the heavens and the earth, nor of the unseen, you judge between your servants regarding that which they have disputed and differed. So guide me to what they have been misunderstood about and the dispute of regarding the truth by your leave, because verily you're the one who guides to the Sirat Mustaqim. So as I said before, my dear brothers and sisters, as I mentioned last week in my previous khutbah, that we should say this dua of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. We should be in the habit of praying for one another. We should be in the habit of trying to advise one another and trying to rectify one another. Because none of us are perfect, my dear brothers and sisters. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make this other dua, اللهم أرنا الحق حقا. Oh Allah, show me the haq, the truth as truth. And أرزقني اتباعه. And give me the ability to follow that truth. And اللهم أرنا الباطل باطلا. And oh Allah, show me the batil, that which is not truth. And أرزقني اجتنابا. And give me the ability to stay away from that, yani wrong action. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm telling you and I'm telling myself that if we do not come back to our asas, our foundation, which is that we تعمرون بالمعروف وتنحون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله, then we're never ever gonna fulfill our commitment. We're never ever gonna fulfill yani the order which Allah Azza wa Jalla, the blessing that Allah Azza wa Jalla has bestowed upon us. We can be living our whole lives and not realize this great blessing that Allah Azza wa Jalla, He akhrajna, He had chosen us, He astafa, He has chosen whoever He wants, and He akhrajna, He chosen us out of all of mankind to be the best. Kuntu khair ummatin ukhrajat linnas, that we are the best people who Allah Azza wa Jalla has chosen. Allah has taken us out of all of mankind. If we do these things, when we see something wrong, then we have to try to change it. We cannot cry after the wrong has been committed and try and find somebody to blame. May Allah give us a tawfiq to be real, true Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be at that pinnacle, that state as the Sahaba were. They weren't afraid to speak the truth. Whenever they seen something wrong, they would say that is wrong. If they could change it, they would change it, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by his hands. And if they can't, by your tongue. And at least we should hate it in our hearts. We shouldn't try and find anyone to blame for what happened in Pakistan and what the retaliation was and what's going to continue until we look at ourselves and change ourselves. Inshallah. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallam tasliman. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار أقيم الصلاة